Hello Sun. So let's start with 6th standard science chapter number 14. We will continue that lesson. Next topic we will see today. So children, up till this we have seen the information about water. Then we have seen formation of clouds. After that we will see water cycle. So today's topic in this video is water cycle. So in this chapter 14 water we will see water cycle, and in that we will see the topics evaporation, condensation, transpiration, precipitation and infiltration or surface runoff. We will see all these topics and terms and how they are related with water cycle we will see today. Now we will see about water cycle. The process of circulating of continuous movement of water between water bodies like ocean, rivers, ponds, lakes and land is called the water cycle. It is also known as the hydrologic cycle or the hydrological cycle. In this process, the water on the earth changes into three different states of matter, solid, liquid and gas, and the complete process of the water cycle involves the steps evaporation, condensation, transpiration, precipitation, filtration or surface runoff. And these are the steps involved in the water cycle. So we will see one by one. Water cycle, the cyclic movement of water from the atmosphere to the earth and the back to the atmosphere through various processes is called as water cycle. Different steps of water cycle include evaporation, transpiration, condensation, precipitation and surface runoff. So we will see evaporation now. As you can see in the figure also, water bodies are heated up with the help of sun's heat, and that water gets converted into water vapor. The water present on the surface of oceans evaporates by the sun's heat. And this process of conversion of water from liquid state to vapor state is called evaporation. Evaporation also takes place from wet clothes, fields, ponds, lakes and rivers. We have seen this in the activity when we are keeping the clothes on the clothesline. And in the figure you can see the sun heats up the water from oceans, lakes and rivers, and water changes into water vapor by the process of evaporation. After that we will say about transpiration. Plants take in water from the soil to prepare their own food and also for other life processes. And they release excess water into the air in the form of water vapor by the process of transpiration. As you can see in the figure, the plants are releasing water in the atmosphere. So plants also lose water in the form of water vapor from their leaves into the air by the process of transpiration. After that we will say about condensation. The evaporated water means water vapor being lighter, means they are very lighter, so it's carried away by the warm air. As the warm air moves higher from the surface of the earth, it starts cool down and turn back into liquid, that is condensation process. Water vapors are lighter, so they goes up, and at the top the area is cooler, atmosphere is cool. So as the cool air that vapors are getting, again condensation starts, means that water vapors are converting into drops of water, and that process is called condensation. So this water vapor condenses to form tiny water droplets which float in air to form clouds or fog, and this process is called condensation. Here you can see in the figure, the water body is getting heated by the sun's heat. Okay, then after that the water vapors are rising up. Here on the top, that vapors are getting cool atmosphere, and that vapors are converted into tiny drops of water. As you can see in the figure, as the water vapor rises up into the air, it starts cooling down and forms tiny water droplets. And these water droplets come together to form clouds. We have seen this in the previous video, that water droplets are gathering together and it are appearing as a cloud. When the clouds start getting heavy and cannot hold the water droplets anymore, they fall back to the earth in the form of rain, hail or snow. as you can see in the figure. Now we will see about precipitation. We have seen evaporation, we have seen transpiration, we have seen condensation. Now we will see about precipitation. All these droplets collect to form bigger drops of water. They are gathering together and they are forming a bigger drops of water. Bigger water drops come down as rain by the process of precipitation. As they are getting heavy, they are coming down on the earth. If the air is too cold, the water drops can become snow or hail and may settle on the top of the mountain. This may occur in the form of rain, hail, snow or sleet depending upon the temperature conditions. When the snow or hail melts, they can become part of a river or a stream. After raining, we can see the water is flowing here and there. So now we will say about surface runoff or infiltration. Some amount of water is absorbed by the soil and settles down as groundwater. Most of the rainwater flows down the hills and the mountains to collect into rivers, lakes or streams. Rain also washes away the topmost layer of the soil into water bodies. The precipitation either runs off into oceans, means that water is running into oceans, rivers and ground surface, or is absorbed by the soil. Either it is getting running, either it can be absorbed by the soil, and that process is called infiltration. And this circulation of water through all these different factors is called water cycle. As you can see in the figure, some of the water that falls on the earth seeps into the ground. This water is available to us in the form of groundwater. Here that water seepage occurs, and underground we can see that water, we can get that water. And some of the water that falls on the earth seeps into the ground. This water is available to us in the form of groundwater, as you can see here. Rain. If the water during precipitation remains liquid till it reaches to the surface of the earth, we have rains. Then we will say about hail or snow. Sometimes we can see rain is coming. In some areas, hail or snow is coming. So it depends upon the temperature only. Sometimes precipitation may be in the form of hail or snow. Water in a hail or snow is in its frozen or solid form. Then dew. Many times, especially during winter nights, the air near the surface becomes quite cool. As a result, the water vapor present in it condenses to form water droplets. And these water droplets appear as a dew. Especially in winter season, we can see that. The remaining water falls back into the ocean, lakes, rivers and seas. This process is called collection, means all water is getting together. The sun starts heating up this water once again. Again, it is just like a chain. So again, after it collecting together, again it starts heated by the sun. So what is water cycle? So water cycle, also known as hydrologic cycle, it is a continuous movement of water from the earth's surface to the atmosphere and then back to the ground. It is a continuous process, means it just like a chain. Hence, it does not have a starting or ending point. Thus, the water present on the earth has been in circulation since the evolution of the earth. Water goes through all the three states, solid, liquid and gas, in this process. There are several factors that assist the water cycle: the sun, air currents, to name a few. Just like evaporation, condensation, precipitation. These are the processes. Transpiration also. These are involved in the water cycle, and water cycle plays very, very important role in the nature ecosystem. Here you can see the figure of water cycle. Here these are water bodies. And sun, because of sunset, water is getting heated up, water bodies. Then water vapors goes up. This process is called evaporation. Then after that, Plants are also releasing some water vapors in the atmosphere. That process is called transpiration. After that, this water vapors are, as they are going higher up in the atmosphere, because of cool atmosphere, again that water vapors are condensed and tiny droplets are formed. After that, precipitation occurs. That tiny droplets gathering together, and when they are becoming heavy, they are coming on the earth. So that process is called precipitation. Here surface runoff is there, means some of the water body, some of the water is falling on the surface of the mountains and it is mixing into the water bodies. And infiltration means some of the water is seepage of water occurs through the soil. So these are some processes, and this is a figure of water cycle. Now we will see water cycle. So watch video carefully, children.
Our topic for today is water cycle. The sun heats up the water from oceans, lakes, and rivers. And water changes into water vapor by the process of evaporation. Plants also lose water in the form of water vapor from their leaves into the air by the process of transpiration. As the water vapor rises up into the air, it starts cooling down and forms tiny water droplets. These water droplets come together to form clouds. This process is called condensation. When the clouds start getting heavy and cannot hold the water droplets anymore, they fall back to the earth in the form of rain, hail, or snow. This process is called precipitation. Some of the water that falls on the earth seeps into the ground. This water is available to us in the form of groundwater. The remaining water falls back into oceans, lakes, rivers, and seas. This process is called collection. Then the sun starts heating up this water once again. This circulation of water is called water cycle.
So we have seen, children, water cycle. We have seen evaporation, transpiration, condensation, precipitation, infiltration, and surface runoff. Thank you for watching video. Keep watching videos again and again for better understanding. And start reading the lessons also. Find out the hard words meanings, whichever new for you. So thank you for watching video.